Hey, can you believe it's been 50 years since the hills were alive with the sound of music?
The hills are alive with the sound of music, with songs they have sung for a thousand years.
That, of course, is Julie Andrews in 1965. She played the young nun who sang her way into the hearts of the Von Trapp family. And, of course, our guest host, Nicholas Hammond, played one of those children, Friedrich. I have a confession to make, Nicholas. I only saw The Sound of Music for the very first time last night.
What?
Leave the room.
Yeah. But the good news is she loves it.
I loved it. Thank you. It was epic.
Do you think it's going to be a success?
I think it'll do really well. We're really hoping. It's such a beautiful movie. And I was so surprised to read that when you auditioned for the film all those years ago, when you were 14, I think, you did so with a broken arm.
Yeah, I did.
And you couldn't sing.
And broken teeth.
Well, I hadn't sung professionally. I got the audition telegram from my agent right after we came back from a Christmas vacation, my family, and I'd fallen down skiing, I'd broken my right wrist, I'd had my two front teeth knocked out, and I'd never sung on stage. I'd worked in plays on stage. So I went into the audition room in New York City. There were 450 other kids there. And I thought, well, I've got nothing to lose. And I was very lucky I was the only one chosen from New York.
But what were the producers looking for? They said, oh, you know, we want someone to play a 14-year-old arch-disciplinarian Austrian child / street thug. what was it that you had, though, in all seriousness?
I was very lucky that Robert Wise, our director, was more interested in people who could handle the dialogue and could act a little bit. He thought, we can always work on the singing. We can teach you the dance routines. And we did. We rehearsed for 3 months before we started filming. So we had plenty of time. I mean, this right here that you're looking at, we were at 20th Century Fox on a soundstage doing all this on a plywood mock-up before we got over to Austria.
Amazing. And you had to dye your hair blonde because you were quite dark.
Yes. Yeah, so the night before we started filming, the director said, I think we've got too many dark-haired kids. Make him blonde.
And you had a huge growth spurt during filming as well.
I did. I grew 6 inches in 6 months. So if you look closely at the film, at the beginning scenes, I'm a lot shorter than the girl who plays Liesel. By the end of the film, I've got my shoes off and I'm in my socks and she's up on very high heels.
With the songs, because they're ingrained in all of our sort of minds and memories, were they hard to learn at the time?
No. I mean, you know, that's why everybody in the world knows them. Mm. I mean, they're wonderful songs that way, because they are like songs children would sing. Mm. But at the same time, I mean, Edelweiss, for instance, to me, is a very beautiful, beautiful song about loyalty and patriotism and love.
Mm. You told me this. You said, 70% of people think it's the Austrian national anthem.
They
and
do.
I went, it's not. I thought it was an old folk tune.
Well, that's it, because in the film where we have all the extras singing along as though it is their anthem, but they all had to learn the words phonetically because they were all German. They didn't speak any English, and they'd never heard it before.
Well, it was the right song for that moment in the movie, wasn't it? Were you all friends? You all seemed to get on very well.
We'd never met before, but, I mean, it was 50 years ago, and those kids then and grown-ups now are still my closest friends in the world. They are.
What do you talk about when you get together? Do you sing the songs or do you?
No, we don't sing the songs. Oh, there we are. Maybe that would have been, I think, 10, 15 years ago. And then we met again. We did a Vanity Fair piece in December. So we met just before Christmas this year. And we're all going to Salzburg in October. So if you want to come to Salzburg, you can see
us. You still do all the actions? So long, farewell.
Sorry. We don't do any of that.
I'm just thinking the goodbyes must take a long time.
We usually end up in the bar and it gets a bit like a Logie's party.
Well, we attempted our own little version
here at
Studio 10. We've recorded just a little something for the anniversary.
Better than the original.
Yeah, I don't know what you're going to think, Nicholas, but let's take a look.
A deer, a female deer.
Hey!
A drop of golden sun.
Me!
A name I call myself.
Ah! A long, long way to
run. So I need a pulling
thread. La, a nut to follow, so.
Tea, a drink with
jam and bread. that will bring us back to
a female deer.
Ray, a drop of golden sun.
Me, a name I call myself.
Far, a long, long way to run.
So, a needle pulling thread.
La, a note to follow so.
Do re mi fa sol la ti do.
And I'm glad you were La, because that was my note.
Oh. You know, I actually read as well that it took you and the kids 6 weeks to film the original.
To film the Do-Re-Mi sequence, that's right. Because, I mean, you say it never rained, or Jonah said it never rained in Salisbury. Believe me, it rained a lot in Salisbury.
Really?
And there were sometimes we could only work one day a week. And so to put that entire sequence together with all the extras and the horse carriages and all the different locations, it was 6 weeks for that one number.
No, Nicholas, look, enough about Sound of Music. I want to talk about your real claim to superstardom, which was as the web crawler, the Amazing Spider-Man in the 1977 to 79 TV series.
And Peter Parker.
That's right. I grew up on this TV series and I just thought all these special effects were the most amazing things I've ever seen.
I know, nowadays you look at it and you think, oh.
Look at that, it's uncanny.
In the suit?
It is me, except when they're up high on the top of a building, then it's not me because of insurance reasons. But I mean, I'm in the suit for about 15% and then I'm Peter Parker, the 85%.
You get changed very, very quickly.
There I am as Peter. Mm. And it was the original Peter Parker.
Yeah. You were the first person to play Spider-Man
live
action?
Yes, ever.
And do you think it's just gotten worse since then?
Oh, no. I think Tobey Maguire was good and I think Andrew was good. I think the guys who have done it in the films have been really terrific. But it was great to do it, fun. And at the same time, I was Marsha Brady's boyfriend on the Brady Bunch. So I was going back and forth between the two. So a couple of 70s TV moments.
Two secret identities.
Imagine if they remade The Sound of Music. Who would play Maria?
Well, that's, to me, the reason they never should.
Yeah,
because there's only one Julie
Andrews.
Can't
mess with perfection.
Well, there's one Julie Andrews. Mm. Yeah. And
I'd like to see a Spider-Man Sound of Music mashup.
I think if you go on YouTube, you can.
Well, it's quite phenomenal that we are celebrating 50 years, the 50th anniversary of The Sound of Music. And guess what? Everyone in the audience is going home with a special two-disc Blu-ray edition. It includes the documentary, The Sound of the City, Julie Andrews Returns to Salzburg. Also available, the Ultimate Collector's Edition of The Sound of Music, which comes with hours of bonus features and a limited edition porcelain cup. So there you go.
It's a teacup.
Yes.
Don't rate me for so large tea.
That's right, Joe.